Morning! Hello and welcome back to our universal portion of our Orlando holiday. We are currently just looking at the gorgeous view. If I can get this open. There we go. Look at that winter Florida morning. Oh, the singer's going. There's still people sleeping.
Is there dirt on that lens?
Oh, it's like watermarks on the show last night. Just gonna clean you up. We're going to head down to the club lounge so we can potentially pick up just like a little breakfast. And then we're heading into the park for early entry. And that is 8 a.m. at Islands Adventure today. They don't do it in Universal Studios as of when we're recording this.
Should probably take a picture of the door.
Just in case you get lost.
I mean, what are the chances?
I mean, they're quite high. Do, 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 London. Do, 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 London. London, England. They are refurbishing a room near the lobby, which makes me think that maybe this is like a temporary one whilst they're reworking it. Oh, very nice. This reminds me of Sound of Music. You are 16, going on 17, fellows will fall in line. Oh! Ow! I sprained my leg. So, I won't do musical numbers in future. So we've got juices over there.
Oh, carpet.
We've got a breakfast selection of bagels and stuff. Cans of Coke, bottles of water. So for breakfast, I've got a chocolate donut along with a breakfast sandwich, some breakfast potatoes, and I made myself a little iced coffee, and Gary's got the classic.
Croissant, croissant.
Well, review on the club lounge. It's very nice.
Very nice.
Very nice indeed. Nice team members working in there. The breakfast sandwich I had, which was like a scrambled egg with bacon on a Hawaiian bread, was delicious. You loved your donut.
I love my croissants.
Your watermelon sugar. Ha! Juice.
Very nice.
So, yeah, no, good. I think Club Lounge is basically a small upgrade. Well, it was a small upgrade for us. It depends on like the time that you're coming and stuff like that. But it wasn't that much more to upgrade for these two nights. And Matty, who's one of the tour operators over at Ever After Holidays, and the one guy I normally speak to when I'm booking my holidays, he really recommended it. So, Matty, good recommendation if you're watching. Much appreciated. That's so cool. Ducks are coming to say hello as well. Quack, quack.
More like the ducks are coming to say, this is our patch. Beat it.
This is like the Wildlife Channel. We've got a turtle here, we've got a fish there, and we've got ducks there. If I throw you in, there's the Gary there as well. Goose is swimming very fast today.
I'm amused. Another wonderful water taxi ride.
Yeah, we like the water taxi. Gary especially likes it because no walking!
Also, the sarcasm. As soon as we got going, Rock the Boat, the song started up.
Also, they did an announcement that was like, and please do not use your family members as a flirtation device.
Love it.
Love it. The only problem with coming in the Christmas season is you don't get the magical Islands of Adventure music that I love so much. So, guess we'll just have to come back. Oh, well. Oh, well. Copyright music, gonna have to sing. I know I can't sing like Gary, but I'm just covering the song. Oh.
You good? Come
hey,
on.
Family, for
have a good time.
Yeah,
thank you. Hello.
Oh, no, key card. So bring the premiere basket. Pick it down.
Thank you.
Well, that was and easy. Let's just have a little look at what the Velocicoaster looks like in the fog. Oh, sweet baby Jesus, that's big.
You ready?
Oh my bowels.
Oh my god.
Mystical.
Magical.
Mystical.
Mystery.
Is it upside down the whole time?
Not the whole time, but it does go upside down. I've been really looking forward to this. Nothing like blood-curdling streams in the morning.
Yeah, look, all these people upside down. People's breakfast just falling from the sky.
So in early park hours, it's 40 minutes, which isn't too bad. It was 40 minutes yesterday, like about 4 or 5 o'clock as well, so. Oh God.
You must put all of your loose items, except the park ticket, in the locker. Don't forget to empty your pockets. You will be going through metal detection.
That's so clever. You watch it on YouTube and you think, ah, oh, that looks like fun. It's very intense. Like, we both looked at each other at the end of it and we're like, I'm only doing that once.
That was a lot. 5 out of 5, though.
Amazing roller coaster, really smooth, good thrill. Like, that's probably the scariest thing I've ever been on.
Yeah.
Genuinely never screamed on a ride as much as I did on that one, but to the point where I've nearly lost my voice. I just saw Gary's face the whole way, like...
I was just thinking, if this is the end, did I get the Mickey and Minnie pin in the end? From the 50th?
My life is not complete! I'm gonna be a ghost forever because I have unfinished business! Oh, no. Wandering the world forever to search for the pin!
Endless search for the pin. The conductor's out.
Oh my god, it's even bigger than I remember it to be. Hello!
Yes! Hiya, you alright?
Good, how are you? We know the feeling. When the park first opens, Hagrid's and Velocicoaster get a very long line because everybody's thinking we need to do that first. So it's got a 90 minute wait right now, but we spoke to a team member and says it normally drops down a little bit. So we're gonna come back in a little bit. We're gonna have a little moo moo shiroo.
Around all the little shops.
Around the Wizarding World. And we're also gonna do Finn and Jenny, which is one of Gary's favorite attractions.
Yes, because I love the castle. So it'd be really cool to like be in the castle again.
That's the one I can only do once because that makes me very motion sick. It's only a 15 minute wait. There was once a day where this would be like 2-3 hours.
Yeah, I think it's because of the other two new ones though.
They've kind of replaced it.
Yeah, it's taken all the attention.
Hi. Thank you. They've actually built a new lockers building over here as well. So I think before you used to have to go into that really claustrophobic room to try and put your bags in, do you remember?
Yeah.
But now they've actually created some decent lockers outside and they've themed them very well. So we'll just scan the barcode. Ta-da! We'll see you after the ride! Bye!
Cell phones, wallets, bags and loose change.
I just can't do like the simulator type things anymore. Like that shook me up more than Hagrid's. No. What did we just go on? Velocicoaster.
Velocicoaster was the first one.
But I'd rather do Velocicoaster again than that again.
Oh no. I love the Forbidden Journey just because it has all the characters, all the different elements around the castle, like the forest.
It's very clever and I do appreciate it for what it is.
Who can take a sunrise?
Not yet.
Oh.
Now you can.
Who can take a sunrise?
Hello, good morning. $13 a pop or 3 for $33. Wizarding World. You're spenny. Look, they've got like themed masks. 30 pots of every flavoured beans, chocolate frogs. Cute. I'll tell you what, that your name always gets the good stuff, doesn't it?
So much stuff. Your name is on everything.
Oh, Reese. I love these floating brooms, they're so clever.
Pins for you, sir.
Oh, they've updated the cards, haven't they?
Yeah, oh look, they used to be red.
Yeah, I'm here for another.
How much do you think?
14?
15, so close.
Oh,
a festive stocking. I'm going to take a picture of that.
You can't fit many presents in there.
It's just for show.
Velocicoaster is a demon?
Do you like Velocicoaster? Oh dear.
Oh no.
Okay, cool change.
I'm alone.
That's a nice triangle you've got there.
Yes, my Tim Tinkler.
Oh, wow.
You sing, match this pitch. It's so high that I can barely hear it. Wow, I bet dogs love that note. Oh, yeah, Mariah Carey
who? That was so funny. Match this pitch. Got a spot of Michael Bublé on the way out. Nice morning here. I would actually say that the early morning hours are probably busier than the park just like about 10-11 a.m. So I wouldn't necessarily rush to come for early morning hours. Would you agree with that?
Unless you're trying to desperately get on something specific.
We're going to head back to the resort. Old Gamboir.
Old Gamboir, Alex.
Gary just needs to have a little bit of rest. So we're going to go back to the resort and chill, and that's probably one of the benefits of staying in Universal, is that actually you can...
It's not that far on the boat.
Hop on the boat, have a little chill. We are planning on popping back later this evening to see the Hogwarts projection shows.
And we'll probably wait for Hagrid's then.
Yeah, yeah, because hopefully it'll be a bit quieter then as well. Because most people start in Islands and then go over to Universal Studios if they've got a park hopper. I love this boat ride, it's so... Well, I would say it's so relaxing, but we've probably got rock music playing, haven't we?
I could live in here. I could actually move into the hotel room we're in.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. The alarm has been activated. We are investigating.
I live for the drum.
Please stay calm and stand by.
We popped into the club level lounge to pick up a Coca-Cola and a bottle of water each. There is an alarm that's sounding. We don't know what it is. We don't know what's happening. But we did opt for sitting outside because, you know, if the building's burning, we don't want to be inside.
Indeed.
Yeah, they're just saying, please stay calm. We are investigating the issue. We will let you know what's happening shortly. So, for now, bottoms up. And that's all the drama you're getting. The alarm has stopped. We're going up to the room.
No more beeps.
No more beeps.
Just a little sip sip.
It's funny what like 2 hours in the park can do to you.
I'm exhausted.
You're exhausted. I'm a broken creature. I could feel dishing for one of the Dobbies.
House South Gary. We're going to watch the second vlog through. I've been editing them whilst we've been going along. Just to make sure that you get the content as soon as it possibly can go out.
I know. I'm just a heap of skin and bone.
A beached whale boarding the boat.
Beast.
Gary's legs are hurting as well today because we've been going for quite a while. So you're at the end of your tether now, aren't you?
Yeah. It's nearly wheelchair time. Join me now as we go into sound for a bit of lunch.
Treat yourself.
Enter. Oh, it's nice.
Ooh, very nice.
Hello, it's Gary Cam. We're just waiting for our pizza. Adam's gone to get some Cokes from the club room thing. And I have to say, Universal, you're knocking it out of the park. This resort is absolutely beautiful. I think I said before how much I love it, but I really love it. I love the
like the Mediterranean sort of look and vibe, and it's just beautiful here. Even as I walked in the quick service, I was like, oh, it looks good. I'm really happy. We've still got a little bit to go, so I hope you stay tuned and enjoy the rest of the series. We are back to Disney very, very soon, but for now, we're just enjoying being in the Mediterranean and enjoying Portofino Bay.
The grand pizza reveal.
Give us today this daily pizza. Put each shower in rich our lives.
It smells amazing.
We're going to the pool.
I know, it's hard to believe.
We're just as surprised as you are. We're not normally pool dwellers, but we've had a nice little chill. I've left the vlog uploading. We've got a couple of hours free. We thought, why not?
I've already slept for nearly 2 hours.
Yeah, I've been editing. He's been sleeping beauty over here. But should we go to the quiet pool?
Yeah.
Less bodies.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the type of holiday I could actually, you know, get used to. Just chilling by the pool, eating snacks.
Peeking.
Looking at Mickey Mouse's on someone's drawers.
Listen, you can take me out of Disney, but you can't take Disney out of my soul. It is there.
We found our way into the jacuzzi. I managed to convince Gary to come in too. There's no lifeguard on duty here, and I'm not saving you. But no, we're really... one thing that we've noticed about this resort is very relaxed. And, like, it's a very different vibe to the ones at Disney. I mean, you can have the quiet pools in Disney and stuff like that, but it's obviously more family orientated. I don't think I've seen a child the whole time we've been here in this resort.
No, maybe not. It's very, like... it seems to be, like, adults just... adult-only holiday sort of thing.
Yeah, but like it's mainly couples and older families and everyone who's kind of like, you know, like we got like your grandparents, then you got your older adults, and then maybe like some teenagers and stuff like that. But
yeah.
So yeah, it's been a nice change. We were talking about like how does this compare to like some of the Disney resorts we stayed in, and like we do really love staying at Disney and stuff. So it's hard to kind of pick. If you wanted like more of a slower paced holiday where like you go into the parks a bit, you come back to the pool a bit, this is probably going to be the better one for you. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I feel like because of how close the parks are, you can just hop on the little boat and say, I've had enough for one day.
Yeah, and just do a couple of hours in the morning and do the rides that you want to.
Yeah, so. But you can do that at Disney as well. It's just the fact that here, because the boat seems so efficient, you just feel like...
Well, the theme park's also much closer here. Like, you think Riverside, getting a bus to Magic Kingdom takes 30, 40 minutes?
Yeah.
Like, waiting for it, getting on it, getting off it, that kind of stuff, so... yeah, no, we're having a really nice time, though.
Are we ready?
We're ready. Are you ready? Wrong place.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
I am. Be a nudist.
Oh, you're filming. That was out of context.
I don't know what that was about.
Oh dear.
And you can even chat questions right here.
We're at the front.
It's easy to plan your days at all three Universal Theme Parks and Universal City Walk.
We're about to head through Zeus Landing. Well, actually, technically, we're gonna head through the shortcut, which is just over here to the left, past the Green Eggs and... Oh my God, I've never seen it open.
What?
The Green Eggs and Ham place. It's literally always been closed.
Oh.
Wow.
It's a real life thing.
It is a real life thing. Am I gonna go? No, but I just wanna see it open.
Hagrid is calling us.
I don't necessarily have to do it. I just need to know that there's the option there, you know? Yeah. Right, we're gonna go on Hagrid's Magical Creatures Motorbike Adventure, and then by the time we've got off that, hopefully we'll be able to enjoy the Hogwarts lighting ceremony.
Ooh, lovely.
For Christmas. The drama, the drama.
The Christmas lights, it gets quite spooky when the lights go
I don't down. Think these are Christmas lights. I think they're just always here.
Oh, they're just...
scenic.
Flourish.
We've just got off. Night amazing. Has now fallen. By the time we got on it, it was like dark. And it was like the best. It was even better than when we'd ridden it in the day when we last came.
So good.
Like all the lights are on, you can see all the characters a little bit better. They can control the light on what you're seeing, what you're not seeing.
Really, really, really good.
Like when you lose power, the lights in the bikes turn off and everything like that.
And when you go through the steam and everything, it was like you could see it all. It was really, really good. So.
5 out of 5, no, 5 plus.
5 plus for that.
That is my favourite ride in the world. That is better than Mickey and Minnie's, that is better than everything.
Yeah.
Also, when it gets to like nightfall, the wait time drops significantly. It was 90 minutes before we rode, and now it's down to 60, so that's only, yeah,
not a lot.
We're here for the magical lights at Hogwarts, the Christmas edition. Gary's very excited.
Can't wait. Never seen any of the Hogwarts projections or fireworks things because we've always done like pop, 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 pop.
We've been done by five, haven't we?
Go.
So, yeah. This is exciting. Oh, that's cool.
Good. Quite short, but short and sweet is good. There's not many fireworks in it till the end, so if you're waiting for fireworks, wait till the da-da-da-da-da-da music.
Well, if you want fireworks, I think you're probably better going over to the Cinematic Spectacular next door.
Yeah, the Cinematic Spectacular is really good. But yeah, average. Like, it wasn't breathtaking, but
out
it was
fine. As far as spectaculars go,
great.
The park is now closed. Did you have a magical time?
I did have a magical time. It was really good.
Highlight of the day.
Hagrid's. Sitting at the back, it is wild.
Sit at the back. If you can get on, well, I don't, you can't really request if you can sit at the back. But if you happen to sit at the back, it's great. Right, are we hungry?
I'm hungry and the salmon are leaving. I don't like salmon though.
The rash of the salmon. We're going to try out Hard Rock Cafe. As everyone's clearing out, it might be the case that we get there. They say it's a crazy long wait and we leave. But we'll give it a go. We were wrong for being hopeful.
We were fools.
Oh. I tell you. So, yeah. There's a wait and we don't think we're going to wait. So, homeward bound we go.
Bye.
Whilst the Hard Rock Cafe was a bust, the Hard Rock Hotel is on the way back to our resort, so we might as well just, you know, pop in, see if they've got a nice place to eat.
That lighting was
I know, evil. I was like, ugh! Very homophobic lighting there.
Homophobia.
It's very peaceful.
It is very peaceful, and I definitely think that walking back is a strategy.
Yeah, it is. If you've got good legs and the will to live, whoa.
All the power to you, my love.
All power to you. I do love that boat. The Hard Rock.
I like that you can hear all the crickets and stuff going. Very holiday-y.
I am now checking the floor for said crickets and for lizards.
Is it a lizard or is it a leaf?
Not many leaves. It's probably a lizard.
Oh, it smells amazing in here. It smells like Hollister.
Ooh, this is cool.
Very grand.
Check the phone.
If we can get in. Ooh, that's fun. It's a very cool vibe here at the Hard Rock. Would you agree with that?
What?
It's a very cool vibe here.
Yeah, it's cool, young,
fresh. I feel cool and young and fresh being here. Right, fingers crossed they've got availability.
Christmas
thing. They're cute. Very great first introduction. Shout out to Dawn, the amazing host.
Dawn, the host, was really incredible. She just said, what do you need? We got it.
She very kindly seated us in this lovely booth. And the chicken?
Is that what you want?
I mean, the menu is looking amazing. And also they've got Wagyu beef on the menu as well. It is $56, so we might you know, just ignore that.
Give that swerve.
Gary has ordered the burger.
It's a £5 burger, but we'll see how I go with it. £5 is a lot.
We've now come to the conclusion that, especially in Universal, the portion sizes are crazy big. Yeah. And so we've decided to stop ordering appetizers now because the main comes out and we're already full. I think we've noticed in Disney the portion sizes have definitely got smaller. Would you agree?
Yes, the Disney portions have got smaller, but here it seems like they're just like inflated. Yeah, they're just getting bigger and bigger.
So, I mean, like normally at Disney we'd be able to share a quick service meal, and that's probably becoming less or so now.
Yeah.
I've just tried my cheeseburger. 5 out of 5. Brilliant, I love it. We're now starting the walk back to Portofino Bay, Portofino Bay. Where the crooks and riches, where the crooks and... there was a word I was going to say, but I can't do that. Family friendliness. Where the... Lizards!
I thought you hit on the head, but I thought I was touching it.
This is lovely. Looking at the floor, looking out for lizards. Every time I say lovely, all I hear is, lovely ladies. Les Miserables.
Lizard watcher.
Join me now as I have a breakdown on the way. Why are you having a breakdown, Gary?
Adam just said to me, what did you think of the gelato we had at Islands Adventure?
Well, no, Gary was making a joke of like, I can't even remember today. And then I said, oh, what about the gelato we had earlier? And he was like, gelato? And I was like, yeah, Islands Adventure. I don't remember that. Did we? And I was like, yeah.
And then I said, you're trying to mess with me.
You're trying to mess with me! That's the PG version of what you said.
Yeah, I said a lot more harsh things than that. I said a lot more harsh.
All that joking about gelato has actually made us want gelato. So there is a gelato place here. Hooray! Da, 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 da. Do you know what flavour you want?
No, I didn't know actually.
Oh, they're like the one, it's like proper gelato where it's like on the, it's not a scoop, it's a spread.
Oh, lovely.
Very nice.
Ice cream
at Christmas.
You scream ice cream, we all scream for ice cream. I went for vanilla bean with some chocolate chips. Gary went for the caramel crunch.
Yeah, I'm going to take a picture of it in front of the Christmas tree.
Right, we've been over this before. Every time you try and take a picture, 1 second. Need dramatic effect. Every time you try and take a picture of ice cream or something, it melts and it goes all down your hands, which it's already doing.
Somebody tried to eat their ice cream through their mask.
Stop calling me out because I'm calling you out, all right? And so our Universal trip comes to an end, but join us next week because we're moving over to Yacht Club for the last portion of our holiday.
Back to Disney.
Back to Disney World. So it just leaves us to say thank you very much for watching this portion. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to see all the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching and we will see you next time.